Everything is connected, and each and every topic in spirit science is connected too, perhaps in a deeper way than any of us might know. In a nutshell, that's really what spirit science is about. We're making connections. Connections between our understanding of reality and ideas about the way that things work on a physical, quantum, metaphysical, spiritual, and all manner of ways. If we find that things are not connected, we can add new points to find the connections, the way that science is hoping that finding the Higgs boson will bridge some gaps between the standard model of physics and understand other things like consciousness and gravity. Adding new connections like sacred geometry do just that. Sacred geometry shows us how biological systems interact with each other in nature, and we can copy it to become more in tune with nature and everything, and most importantly, ourselves. All of these ideas are connected. We just have to look at the patterns as to how. We can fractal this idea larger and larger. Just as an animal exists as a part of the ecosystem that it's connected to, so too do we have a connection with our planet in a way that is almost cosmic in nature. In learning to recognize the patterns that exist, such as the trinity between the life-giving sun, Mother Earth, and you, we can learn to understand ourselves in a very powerful way. If you get one thing out of this series, I would hope that I would be able to inspire you to look inward and to look at yourself and the events in your life in a new way, in looking deeper at the world all around you. It's important to let go of ideas that no longer serve you. The realization that I have come to is that all of us, every single person on this planet, are cosmic beings of life and light in the universe. We share a space with all of the energy of infinity, and it's about acknowledging that energy and tuning yourself into it. You are a receiver for cosmic information. Science now shows that we are all made of stardust, the remnants of exploding stars. We have developed our own unique consciousness based on our previous geometry. If our consciousness came from a star, then what's to say that that star and the rest of the universe doesn't also have its own unique consciousness, even if it's not entirely understood yet? On that note, I want to share a short video with you now by performance philosopher Jason Silva about what it means to understand and connect the dots.
Understand is to perceive patterns. Now, of course, what this means is that true comprehension comes when the dots are revealed and you get Stephen Johnson's long view and you see the big picture. This is the idea about patterns, recurring patterns across different scales of reality. You know, Paul Stamets talks about the mycelial archetype and how the information sharing systems that comprise the internet look exactly like computer models of dark matter in the universe, look exactly like the neurons in a brain. They all share the same intertwinkled filamental structure. It's the rise of networkism as big data. Advocates talk about how man-made systems are looking exactly like natural systems. The more we can measure, the more we can visualize, the more expands our consciousness by seeing these recurring patterns across scales of reality. It blows my mind, and I think that technology increasingly is becoming an expander of human consciousness. It extends our thought, reach, and vision, and revealing so much more. It's like, whereas once I was blind, now I can see. Jeffrey West from the Santa Fe Institute is telling us that cities are really like organisms, you know, alleys are like capillaries. How is it possible that a man-made artificial technological system is behaving like a natural system? The more efficient it becomes, the more it's starting to look like nature. Really interesting, weird stuff. But it makes me optimistic. It's like when Stephen Johnson says, look, if we can understand all this stuff, we can, I mean, anything becomes possible, right? It's the adjacent possible, standing as a sort of shadow future, a map of all the ways the present can reinvent itself. It's beautiful stuff.
Now, let's take this one step deeper, because I know there's one aspect about this that a lot of people are hesitant about. It's the use of this word, spirit, in conjunction with this word, science. Many people feel that these words need to be kept separate, although I will share that in my experiences, I've learned that magic can happen when powerful energies come together. In fact, it's the very nature of physics and our own sun. Our sun is a fusion reactor which provides all of the energy and life for the entire planet, whereas vision, on the other hand, has been used to blow up and demolish entire cities. So, which do you really prefer? I find it really interesting too, as the discussion of God has been the most sought discussion of our evolution and history for thousands of years. Ideas like God, Source, Spirit, and Essence are all ideas that can be used to expand our perception of everything in the universe to a broader, more encompassing understanding. less of a creator god caricature than it's typically perceived as. If you look deep, beyond all of the dogma of any religion, and yes, there's lots of dogma, and really get in tune with the ideas themselves, God, or Source, has always been described as the creation force of the universe itself, the creation force of reality, the driving life essence that moves through everything. In modern science, we pretend that this is not the question that we're asking, but it really is. We can see scientifically that everything in reality is vibrating waves of light, and we can look to our ancient past to see that pretty much everyone says that the light itself is the creation force. It's not just in the Bible that the light came first. Pretty much every ancient culture believed this, from the Mayans to the Egyptians. We're coming full circle. The leading theories and ideas about the universe now depict how the entire reality is like a giant living organism that grows and evolves and manifests new things. The Big Bang is the breath of source energy from which everything manifested. All of the parameters for the structures of the universe were defined within the first nanoseconds of the Big Bang. It wasn't random, there was a fundamental pattern at the core of that creation. It was geometric in nature. The creative expression of the universe manifests as our reality that we are a part of, and we too are creators within that creation, free to create whatever we want, limited only by our imaginations and ability to spill our thoughts over from our minds and into the physical world. Okay, we're wrapping it up now, so here's the spirit science theory. Is it possible that what spirit or God is actually this hierarchy of awareness, of consciousness, as it manifests at different levels of existence through the universe? Consciousness itself is not this extrapolated aspect of the universe that we just so happen to inhabit, nor is it only subject to exist through biological life. But rather, the whole of the universe itself is conscious, and that is how it exists in the first place. If the sun provides the life essence for the planet, then that energy must be alive in some sense of the word, though scientifically we're having trouble comprehending it. This idea basically says that just as a blood cell is one conscious being that coexists within your body as a part of it, so too are we just one blood cell to our planet, Mother Earth, who is a conscious being, and she's completely aware of you in every which way. Mentally, emotionally, physically, and spiritually. You're a part of her. You're part of her system. Do you not feel it when your stomach hurts or when you scrape your arm? Especially since we feed ourselves with lots of junk that we know isn't good for us. We're creating hurt, separation, and war on this planet, and she in turn is hurting too. And by healing ourselves, we are healing her. The next revelation is that creation and evolution are two sides of the same coin. The creation force itself is consciousness, and evolution is the change that the creation experiences as it continues to create more, as its understanding grows. This is demonstrated through the life and death of a star, or the life and death of a cell, especially if death isn't the end, but a recreation, a transition of energy into a new state of being. That would make sense, especially when we consider how we came from exploding stars. In Fibonacci, we continually add the current number to the previous in order to expand the spiral and continue growing. What we're doing now is taking our modern understanding of the world and the universe and adding all of our ancient understanding to it. The ancients told us that God existed within, and the keys to the universe lie in our hearts. Jesus and Buddha taught that through love, we can become the gods that we truly are. And now it's time to step into that. As we move forward into the future, the time has come to reconnect with ourselves and step into divine revelation through truth, love, and oneness. Thank you.